Offices of Displace International, Midtown Manhattan, New York City, USA. Displace International has been protecting Zerkheizi, who contracted Lacerda to kidnap Morgenhold. It must be determined if Displace is merely protecting Zerkheizi or if they are also involved in the plot to acquire the Mars Girls. Greetings, fellow Olympics. Welcome back to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Chaos Theory, played in a tactical assault playstyle. Again, a mouthful of a name. But the story thus far is that Displace International has been implicated in all of this. Morgenhold got kidnapped. He was working on the Mars Colonels from Splinter Cell 1, which could be used for information warfare attacks, and were recently used in information warfare attacks in two countries, Japan, Tokyo, Japan, and New York, USA. So the Third Echelon essentially went to investigate Zerkheizi's penthouse because his name popped up. He's another computational theorist who's also working on the Mars Girls. Unbeknownst to them, Doug Shetland was actually using them to... Well, he obtained information about the Mars Girls from Morgenhold, and he used Zerkheizi to build him a Dvorak, which he could use to weaponize the Mars Girl algorithms. So... yeah, the NSA, however, does not know all of that. All the NSA knows is that somehow Zerkheizi was involved, and since he wasn't there and they found Dvorak, his implication is more or less confirmed. However, Displace has also been protecting the area, and there's a possibility that somebody inside Displace could be playing both sides, is what the NSA thinks, which, well, it's actually Douglas Shetland. The blame should have fallen on Milan Nedic, like the Barber of Bosnia, a war criminal. But we sort of botched that objective. So we'll figure that out once we record meetings and interviews and stuff in this level as well. But as far as this level is concerned, it's going to be a little difficult at this playthrough because, well, it's one of those levels where you cannot kill anybody. This is, I think, the only level and the final level in the game. So we're going to have to rely on old school means and use all the gadgets that we have at our disposal to make ends meet. So with that being said, let's go ahead and watch the cinematic.
Now coming to you from our New York City Broadcast Center, we have Patrick Dunn of Watershed Electric on the line. Mr. Dunn, what do we know at this moment?
All we know so far is that this was not an accident.
If it's not an accident, then it must be intentional. Both us and the Japanese have been hit by this thing. I think it's pretty obvious who's responsible.
Here's a Tomo.
It appears we have something in common, Admiral.
Our analysis of the information footprint shows that the pressures which collapsed our power grids appear in many ways similar to those that collapsed our markets. I am certain the Koreans and the Chinese are involved.
Let's not jump the gun here, Admiral. We've had our microscope on a man named Zerkheizi. He had access to weaponized IW algos following that business in Georgia. He was also a major DOE consultant after the blackouts here in 2003.
Yes, we are aware of this connection. Has Zerkheizi been found?
Not yet, but it won't take long. I'll keep you posted.
Fisher, I'm afraid we might be facing an orchestrated attempt to push the world into a major crisis. Zerkheizi might know more about information warfare than anyone on Earth. And the fact that Displace is combat-ready, essentially stateless, and better equipped than most governments, we need to find out fast whether this is a coincidence or whether someone inside Displace is making a major move. That said, State Department has several very significant contracts with Displace. This thing is extremely political. I hate to do this to you, but keep it clean. Recon only, no fatalities.
Displace's offices are on the top three floors of the Hans Center Tower in downtown Manhattan. Recent financials indicate that they have invested heavily in their local infrastructure in order to maintain full operational capacity following even a major terrorist incident.
Like this one?
Satellite confirms Grimm's data. Displace is up and running at near to full capacity. It looks like they might be holding a meeting with members of New York City Council, possibly making a bid for protection or policing services to supplement the National Guard. They're prepared and opportunistic, that's for sure. But I wouldn't expect anything different.
A little too prepared.
My money says they're playing fair, but if the boss wants to take a closer look, then that's what we'll do.
They actually are not playing fair, but you guys don't know that yet. I can see you trying to give them the benefit of the doubt, and I suppose that's a good character trait. But this is one of the things that I love about this game, how this entire franchise, really. At least the first three games in the franchise, the OG trilogy, as the community likes to call it, does not shy away at all from talking about, you know, all the shady politics behind the scenes, such as government contracts being totally reliant on displays, and how, you know, the government doesn't exactly want to investigate them as openly, because even though they might be a private company who could be going against their interests, a lot of their interests are tied up with displays. So yeah, I mean, if Lambert decides to go to the Joint Chiefs with this, they might just throw a fit. So he's going to keep this under wraps, and he's going to do it silently on his own. Anyway, let's go ahead and address this level then. Now, I don't really know which loadout I would rather take. I think Redding's recommendation is better, at least as far as shooting stuff is concerned. This has gas grenades. This does not have gas grenades. I would actually prefer gas grenades for this level. I've only got flashes and smokes with this. This has gas grenades and airfall rounds. And sticky shockers and sticky camps. I think that is like the far superior loadout, since we cannot actually shoot anybody. I don't see myself using any flash grenades either, because of the very same reason that I cannot enter open combat in this scenario. So yeah, we'll stick to this then. We'll try to keep it hand to hand as much as possible. And if I see clusters of enemies, I'll just go ahead and use gas grenades and stuff, which is what I'm planning to do with the first meeting at entry 8. Let's go ahead and address this level then.
Fisher, we need to find out if Displace and Zerkheizi are working together.
But until we know, you want me to keep it quiet.
Don't kill anyone or I'll abort the mission. The Pentagon has contracts with Displace all around the world. The President will have puppies if he finds out we're doing this.
Hey, Marco asked me to ask you when you can finish getting the ventilation system.
I don't know. You know why?
Well, Marco says hurry up. He says the air is getting stale inside.
The hell do I care what Marco said? I don't even know it.
No, tell him you said that.
Go ahead.
Boy, are you in trouble.
Whatever. What's that? I heard something.
Little help
here! Where are you running, son? I thought that would knock the bolt out, but it did not, to my dismay. So let's just go and switch this object here. Starting off with some action, but then again, that's pretty much why we decided to go through with this playthrough in the first place. Right, I keep forgetting. Open the trap and head to this thing here. Rappel down. One of the things that I dislike is that you cannot invert yourself while grappling in this game. You can do that in R6 Vegas. But then that game is that game, and this game is this game. It would be unfair to compare the two.
Certainly entitled to request protection at that level from the National Guard, I agree. But let's face it, the National Guard is a massive, cumbersome organization.
Sure, that's what we need, a presence.
On the contrary, the people...
Hey, who's that?
Who's what?
I just saw someone, down there!
Don't kill me!
Fisher, be careful with the law.
I guess that's what we're
going to do.
The nest is for the young and the cowardly.
Yep, that's fine. Did not go as smoothly as expected, because I remember being able to accidentally knock literally everybody out with one gas grenade before, but I sort of had to eliminate all the gas, use up all the gas grenades here. Oh well, whatever works, I suppose. Don't get your panties up in a bunch. You're not in trouble. Oh, where's the laptop that we need to scan? Ah, right there. Can we like... Yeah, we can. 192 and 40. It's not 68. It must be 67 or 66. Don't even know the last digit there. 66, 40, and it's not 30, so it's 40, right? Lobby area tokens. Julian, for Tom's visit, I've changed the tokens between the ops room and the main lobby. The new code is 8136. It's the same for both doors. Cool.
Good work, Sam.
Server access algorithm.
Now you'll be able to access the central server on the first floor.
This wireless stuff makes life a lot easier.
Yep. Welcome to the Wi-Fi era.
Remember, you're saying that to a guy from the era of hi-fi.
Hi-fi? As in, like, high in fiber?
Don't put me in adult undergarments yet, kid.
That's true. He's not in adult undergarments yet. Now, where do we want to go? Let's go over to here first.
Each of Displace's different divisions seem to have their own server farm. I put a program on your OPSAT that will build a little back door into their networks.
You want me to upload that to each division server?
I would appreciate it.
Since you asked so nice.
68191. Only one number.
Good work, Sam. That's the first of their servers. If you can upload that to each of the other ones, I'll be able to snoop around as much as I please.
I'll see what I can do.
Of course you will. Won't you, Sam? Did somebody run away or something? Now, there's that guy over there, but I would rather like to get a cleaner shot on him. Well, that's that. This guy is gonna go for a leak, so I'll just let him go. Okay, the music cut off all of a sudden, which is strange. Never had that happen to me before. I guess this is the first time for everything though. Since stealth is the name of the game, might as well leave a few guys intact while we can. 10. Not 194. 40. 192. Right.
Good work, Sam. Upload that program to the last server and you'll make me the happiest girl in the world.
You're easy to please.
Access is a girl's best friend.
I suppose it is. Alright, moving ahead, moving on. That guy's still taking a piss? What? Probably should not have fixated there, but over. Well, that guy still is taking a piss. I mean, you've been holding it for a long time, haven't you?
Identification
completed. One of the more cooler moments of this franchise, you can just take this guy's body and use it to your advantage. I mean, it sort of sucks when you put it that way, but yeah. You can't do that. Someone take a look in the lobby and make sure those guys are not napping, said the other guy.
It's a pretty cushy posting, that's for sure.
But I heard the guy was really annoying.
Guy isn't there anymore. He's out of town.
What, so you're just watching his stuff?
Yeah, emptying his liquor cabinet and playing video games. He's got the new Prince of Persia.
Yeah, I heard it's awesome.
It's gonna be game of the year, man.
Can't wait to play it.
So you can actually eliminate individual numbers using the E key. I think that guy goes upstairs.
got any plans for the long weekend?
Jesus, 4th of July coming up. I forgot.
You forgot? How could you forget?
Ugh, you know, been putting in crazy hours. Don't even know what day it is.
Yeah, I know what you mean. Me and Anne-Marie are gonna head up to Maine, stay in a little bed and breakfast, eat some lobster.
Do they have power back in Maine yet?
Power? Whoa, forgot about that.
Yeah, how could you forget?
Right then. Probably could have tried to go up there while this guy had his back to him, but oh well. I suppose I like doing it this way. Ten. Last number is 10. 194 with 10 at last. That's three numbers. It's not 66, not 67, so 68. Only one number left. I'll close this door behind me to be polite. Another security access. It's not 30, it's 40 though. And it's not 10, it's not 20, so it must be 40.
Thanks, Sam. That's the last one. I can't wait to sniff around and displace his laundry basket. What?
Laundry. I totally forgot.
The good thing is I still have three sticky shockers left, so I suppose they planned this level out pretty well. Sometimes you need to remove anything from the computer before you can use it again.
It looks like someone shunted the data we need off the server. Login name, M. Nedich.
M. Nedich? Who's that?
Fragments here. Looks like he's VP of Protection Operations for Displace.
He protected Zerkheizi and Morgenhold? Either he's not very good at his job or he's dirty.
Echelon has nothing on him. Looks like he's been zeroed.
Probably a pseudonym. I'll see if I can find out who he really is.
In any case, we need to get access to his computer. His office should be on the upper floor somewhere.
Should be indeed. Hopefully this guy does not notice that the store has been hacked yet. Sometimes he does, I don't know why. He just notices it sometimes out of the blue. Go on, move with me. You've got no business being here. I mean, you do have business being here, but I would rather that you were not here.
Like it should. Someone's been up to something.
Hasn't somebody? Confirm. It's strange. I mean, you can hear them talking over the radio about how things aren't the way they're supposed to be. At the same time, nobody actually comes to check on these guys. Maybe they could do something about it in the upcoming remake, or maybe they have already done it and I just don't know about it. Need to take those lights out, or at least the camera out, while I call the elevator. And the elevator takes forever to arrive.
I'm serious, Sam. Too many alarms and these mercenaries will be after you.
So I would suppose. That should be natural.
What is that?
What is what? Oh, you there. Okay. No worries. If you've heard that story already, so I'm not really gonna pay much attention to it. It's like sounds of
out of town, so there won't be a VIP, just the property.
Okay, sounds like a breeze.
Well, it hasn't gone perfectly smooth so far. You'll get the full VIP rate, and you'll be on duty as though there is a package on site.
Lights busted.
Okay, got it.
Good. You report at 1300 tomorrow.
Okay, I'll be there.
Good grab, Fisher. Milan Nedich's real name? Jesus. Milos Nowak.
Milos Nowak, who is he?
The barber of Bosnia. Suspected war criminal from the Bosnian conflict. Allegedly scalped some of his prisoners.
Wanted in The Hague?
Yeah.
Bet you dollars to dinars that he doesn't make it to trial.
That's okay. I think my money's safer on the Nikkei.
Now, should we knock him out right now? I suppose it makes sense. Or maybe we just let him go. Yeah, go on. Don't come back here. We'll have to hack this keypad. 20, 194, 20. Only one number here. We could actually probably get the code from this guy instead of hacking it, because, well, why not? Where's this guy's face? Right, you can't see it.
Nice suit. Italian?
Oh no! Italian. Yes, the Florentine silk. Andretti?
Who's Andretti?
Andretti? The famous designer. Men's suits, tuxedos.
I'm not a tuxedo kind of guy.
But you are some kind of spy.
Yeah, I'm the real kind. Not the tuxedo kind. I'm the kind of spy who gets blood all over your Andretti unless you give me information.
Oh God, please don't ruin my suit.
How about a door code?
CEO's office, 2609.
I'm gonna take this guy with me and I'm gonna like put him into this room here.
I didn't know you could hack these things.
Yeah, that's why I wanted to put him in this room so that he does not get caught. Because this guy is probably gonna come inside and check. Yep, he used his key code there to come inside.
Are you okay there? Respond.
One of the downsides of using this mod is that you can peek through walls. Well, if you're just gonna... Oh, okay. It doesn't hurt to be cautious. Two six zero nine. You can just use a numpad on your computer to enter the codes. So this is the computer that you need to access, and that is not Milan Nedic. None of them are. Those are just the developers of the scheme.
Hokkaido.
Hokkaido? Isn't that basically the Alaska of Japan?
Yeah. Looks like Milan Nedic has secretly relocated Zerkheizi there.
Interesting. Now we definitely need to talk to Shetland.
We'll let State Department handle that mess. You're going to Hokkaido. We're sending a helicopter to evac you from the roof.
No, I'm gonna just pull out the pistol and use the hack to move faster. Because why not? 3485. The thing is, I've already played this game in the stealth mode, so not particularly interested in doing that. Alright, time to extract. And that was that for Mission Penthouse. We got every objective completed, so I'm sort of concerned that we will probably get like a pretty high score with this level. Not that I'm trying to get a low score, but yeah. So we came in trying to figure out who's in charge of the Zerkheizi protection detail. Turns out it's Milan Nedic, a war criminal wanted by the International Court of Justice. The issue is, well, this more or less puts the focus on Nedic instead of, you know, Milos Novak. This puts the focus on Novak instead of the actual person who they should be focusing on, that is Shetland. And this is essentially another one of the layers of insulation that Shetland had created for himself. He understands information warfare very well, and these are all just deceptions that he had placed so that, well, he could be insulated from directly being detected right off the bat. First, it was La Cerda, then it was the Panamanian Bank, then it was Zerkheizi, and then it was this guy right here, Nedic. Unfortunately, he has not put up any further defenses, and he has to rely on other drastic measures for, well, diversions, which we'll get to see in the cinematic of the next episode, when we actually go over to Hokkaido to figure out what Zerkheizi is really up to, and we essentially go to abduct him, basically. So with that being said, let's look at the statistics. 90%, oh no, that's a really high score. Oh well, whatever works, I suppose. So that's that for Mission Displace. Thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. This is gonna screw up my total at the end, but oh well. At any rate, we'll see you in Hokkaido. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow Earthlings.